Well, the DA Federal Council has deferred a decision that is threatening to derail its selection of 2019 election candidates for legal opinion. The proposed amendment, reportedly put forward by Federal Executive Chair James Self, was looking to give more power to provincial leaders in the selection of these candidates, but 34 delegates shot it down.
A confident official opposition hoping to edge closer to the seat of government, but the process to select candidates remains contentious. Federal Executive Chair James Self says many provincial leaders believe they should be members of selection panels to ensure candidates have skills, capacity and diversity, but 34 senior party members, among them DA Chief Whip John Steenhuisen, say it will give provincial leaders unchecked power and promote factionalism.
As leader of the DA, I decided that it'd be important for us to set up a body that met last night. That body discussed whether the regulations will be consistent with the constitution of the DA so as to ensure that when people stand before a selection panel, the processes are fair, they are transparent, that there is no gatekeeping, and that at the same time as all of that, to uphold the principle of saying that there's constitutional consistency. That body met, it made a recommendation to Federal Council. Federal Council has submitted that issue to a legal opinion, and so as things stand at the moment, we will ensure that where there are provincial variations, that those are withdrawn, that ultimately the legal opinion will guide the process going forward.
The party has also extended the deadline for nomination of premier candidates to the 18th of August. There may be internal wrangling, but the DA is beginning to sell its offering, topped by economic reforms. Maimane says the country does not need South African Airways. It must be sold.
The DA will also make proactive proposals to reduce the levy payable to the Road Accident Fund, to provide immediate relief to consumers, and to reduce the tax proportion payable on fuel over time to get it back to a reasonable level.
On coalitions, Maimane says they are here to stay. The party has also weighed in on the latest regarding VBS Bank.
The PIC has made certain investments that you read about retrospectively. I think they must account properly to Parliament. And that ultimately those who are committing criminal effects, especially around VBS, those officials must be charged.
The DA says it will join the country and the world in commemorating the Nelson Mandela centenary. Ntakwana Ngatane, SABC News, Johannesburg.